हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। माई सेल्फ मनीष कुमार सिंह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर बॉटनी, डीके कॉलेज उमरा। टुडे आई एम हेयर विद न्यू यूट्यूब लेक्चर। इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट डिफरेंट टॉपिक्स ऑफ सेल बायोलॉजी, दैट इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन प्रोकैरियोट एंड यूकैरियोट, डिफरेंस बिटवीन प्लांट सेल एंड एनिमल सेल, अल्ट्रा स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ राइबोसोम, गॉली बॉडी, एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम एंड देयर फंक्शन। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अ न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज नोन एज अल्ट्रा स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शन ऑफ माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द टॉपिक आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू द हिस्ट्री ऑफ माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया, दैट इज साइंटिस्ट कोलिकर इन 1880 फर्स्ट डिस्कवर्ड द माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया फ्रॉम स्ट्राइडेड मसल ऑफ इंसेक्ट। After that, the scientist Altman in 1890 first coined the term bioplast for mitochondria, and the scientist C. Bender in 1897 coined the present name of mitochondria. All these three points are asked in your examination and various computer examination, like who first discovered the mitochondria, who first coined the term bioplast, or which cell organelle is known as bioplast, and who gave the present name of mitochondria. All these are questions. Now we would like to introduce you the shape, number and occurrences of mitochondria. Regarding the shape, माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया इज वेरिएबल इन शेप, बट इन केस ऑफ प्लांट जनरली द शेप ऑफ माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया इज स्फेरिकल टू रॉड शेप, रॉड लाइक। एंड व्हेन वी सी द नंबर ऑफ माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया पर सेल, वी फाइंड दैट नंबर ऑफ माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया इज मोर इन एनिमल सेल एज कंपेयर टू द प्लांट सेल, बिकॉज एनिमल सेल्स आर मोर एक्टिव देन द प्लांट सेल, दे रिक्वायर मोर एनर्जी इन कंपेरिजन टू द प्लांट सेल, दैट्स वाई नंबर ऑफ माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया इज मोर इन एनिमल सेल। दस वी कंफर्म दैट मोर एक्टिव द सेल, मोर नंबर विल बी द माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया। इवन इन द केस ऑफ प्लांट, डिफरेंट प्लांट सेल हैव डिफरेंट नंबर ऑफ माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया पर सेल। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द मेसोफिल सेल ऑफ एरेबिडोप्सिस कंटेन 200 टू 300 माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया पर सेल, वाइल अ डिफरेंट प्लांट द मेसोफिल सेल ऑफ टोबैको सेल कंटेन 500 टू 600 माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया पर सेल। नाउ वी विल सी वेयर माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया इज फाउंड एंड वेयर इट इज एब्सेंट। माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया इज प्रेजेंट इन all eukaryotic cell like plant cell, animal cell, while it is absent in prokaryotic cell like bacteria, blue green algae. We also know that blue green algae are also known as cyanobacteria. Mitochondria is the site of aerobic respiration, where respiration occurs in the presence of oxygen. The cell where mitochondria is absent, the cell respire anaerobically. That's why for aerobic respiration, mitochondria is essential. Now we will study the structure of mitochondria. As I have already told you that it is a double membrane structure found in all eukaryotic cell. Now look, this is the structure of mitochondria. It is a double membrane structure. This one is outer membrane. This is known as inner membrane. And in between these two membranes, there is a space. That space is known as perimitochondrial space or intermembranal space. Outer membrane is smooth and continuous. You can see it is the continuous. while inner membrane is discontinuous. It invaginates inside matrix to form finger-like structure. This is the finger-like structure. This one is finger-like structure. This finger-like structure is known as cristae. Now, cristae contain tennis racket-like structure. This is the tennis racket-like structure. These structures are known as F0 F1 particle or oxysome or elementary particle. It has three different names. F0 F1 particle, oxysome and elementary particle. These F0 F1 particle contain enzyme that is known as ATP synthetase. It uses the energy of proton gradient that develops during electron transport chain to produce ATP. It is known as oxidative phosphorylation in mitochondria to produce energy. We will discuss electron transport chain and proton gradient in next YouTube lecture. Now we see that inside mitochondria there is a semi-solid liquid. This liquid is known as matrix. Same type of liquid is also found in chloroplast, but where these liquid are known as stroma. That is the difference between stroma and matrix. Matrix is found in mitochondria while stroma is found in chloroplast. Now we see that in matrix there is DNA that is double-stranded and circular. It is similar to the bacterial DNA. And DNA replication of mitochondria is independent of nuclear DNA. And the size of genome of mitochondrial DNA vary from 200 to 2400 kilo base pair. In matrix, we also see that there is a single-stranded RNA and ribosome. These ribosomes are of 70S type, that is similar to prokaryote. And in matrix, there are many fat droplets that are known as fat globuli. This is the basic structure of mitochondria. Now, I will explain some special point about the structure of mitochondria. That is, when we see the inner membrane is divided into two parts. One is known as IBM, that is known as inner boundary membrane. It is present near the outer membrane, or you can say parallel to the outer membrane. This one is IBM, inner boundary membrane. And second one is known as cristae membrane, that is protruded out in the matrix. This is the invaginated part. It is known as cristae membrane. Cristae is attached to the inner boundary membrane through a tubular pore. Here is the pore that is known as cristae junction. And this one is outer membrane. Outer membrane contains 8 to 10% of total protein of mitochondria. These proteins are involved in biogenesis and morphology of mitochondria. While inner membrane, its surface is very large as compared to outer membrane. As we know that it invaginates, that's why its surface area increases. Hence, inner membrane contains more than 50% of total mitochondrial protein. And these proteins are also divided into two parts. Protein present in IBM and protein present in cristae membrane. proteins that are present in inner boundary membrane are involved in fusion of mitochondria and transport of protein that are encoded by nuclear genome. While protein present in Christi membrane, they are mainly involved in oxidative phosphorylation, that we know that formation of ATP. And these protein help in transport of DNA that is encoded by mitochondrial DNA. This is the difference between protein present in IBM and CM, Christi membrane. These are the basic structure of mitochondria. I think you are very clear from the figure that structure of mitochondria is very typical. Now we will study the function of mitochondria. Mitochondria is the site of aerobic respiration. I have already explained it. Number first. Number second, oxidative phosphorylation occurs in mitochondria where energy is produced in the form of ATP. And third function is some essential fatty acid and amino acids are also synthesized in mitochondria. We know that Krebs cycle occurs in matrix of mitochondria. That's why there are many intermediate compounds that are produced during the Krebs cycle. These intermediate compounds are used in synthesis of many biomolecules like cytochrome, phytochrome, pigments like chlorophyll, etc. Mitochondria contain its own DNA, RNA and protein. That's why mitochondria is also known as semi-autonomous cell organelle. Now this is whole about ultra structure of mitochondria and its function. Now I request you to see the video and think about it, imagine itself and see how the question can be presented before you. There are many questions that can be developed from this topic. For example, who discovered the mitochondria? Who coined the term bioclast? Who gave the present name of mitochondria? Where oxidative phosphorylation occurs? Where electron transport chain occurs? Where Krebs cycles occur? There are many, so many questions that you can find after seeing this video. These questions are very helpful in your classroom examination as well as competitive examination like NEET, Civil Services, Railway, etc., etc. In any competitive examination, you can find objective questions that are related to the ultra structure of mitochondria and its function. This is all about this video. Now, tomorrow we will present with next YouTube lecture with more energy and more power.